Welcome to Education Law. My name is John Pijanowski. I'll be your professor this semester. What I want to do in this video is just share with you a little bit of what the semester will look like. I'll walk you through some of the course materials that you'll be using, and then give you a sense of how to get off to a good start. So we have a course website, which I'm assuming if you found this video, you've already found our course website, and that's going to be the primary portal for all the materials you'll be accessing in your course this semester. You'll have access to the syllabus, hot links to a variety of different types of audio, video, and text-based resources that you'll be using, as well as regular updates with video blogs from me that give you a sense of either my thoughts on how the class is going, some interpretation I have of the materials you're engaging in, or directions for what you should be doing next. We're also going to be using the University of Arkansas Blackboard site for a few things. We'll be using it primarily to host discussions. And so if you haven't used Blackboard discussion board site before, it's fairly intuitive. I think that you'll find that when you're using that site, you'll get more and more comfortable with it, and you'll see that those who are more experienced have ways of using it and identifying the person that they're responding back to, calling them out by name. That you'll find helpful. So I realize that for some of you, this might be the first time you've taken an online class. One of the things that I want to say up front is that I do believe that taking a class like this online has a variety of benefits. And one of them being that you really have time to think about this material and give a measured response. And frankly, that's how it works in the real world. You have time, and knowing when to take that time is a big part of how to work with the law as a leader. So there are some advantages, but I also know that just using new technology can be a challenge until you get the hang of it. We never want technology to be an impediment to your success. We want it to be a tool. And so if you find yourself stumbling through the technology a little bit, don't hesitate to get in touch with me. I'm here to help. You have classmates here who have taken online classes before. They're here to help, and we'll get you where you need to be. So hopefully this will be a good experience for you. The discussion boards I've mentioned are a big part of this class, and so we don't have really major assignments that happen throughout the semester. We have a few things that I'm going to ask you to do, but largely on a week-to-week basis, the discussion boards are not just a supplement to what we do here. They really are the primary way of engaging with each other and with the material. And so in some cases, you may have found that discussion board sites were a supplement to a course. Here, they're really the heart of the course. And so we're looking for perhaps a more substantive approach to them than you've experienced in the past. However, those of you who have had a class with me before, you'll hit the ground running and know what I'm looking for. Now, I do provide some resources online that give a description of what I'm looking for in our discussions. So don't feel like you have to go in blind. Take the time to look at my guide to a good discussion, and if you have questions, feel free to ask. You'll find that throughout the semester, there's a real rhythm to the semester, where on a regular throughout the week, you will have. When you hit the ground running on Monday, the start of each week, you'll have some a discussion that we're going to dive into. You'll have the readings and videos, and I'll have very clear directions about when things are due. And one of those things that I want to emphasize is that while everything is available to you all at once, there is a part of that rhythm that I try to control for a reason. For example, in my discussions, there's something I like to call the turn. And the turn is what happens when everybody has had a chance to contribute to a question or an idea, and nobody has begun to respond to other people's comments yet. So we all get a chance to get our best idea out there, and we wait until what I've designated as the turn. It'll be a very specific time during the week. And at that point, everybody is free to come back, read everything that everybody has written, and then contribute. I think any of you who have been in discussions either live or online particularly, you know that it can be the case that a few people get in early, they start talking to each other, and so you have a class of 20, but really there are only 5 or 7 people who are having a rich discussion. Somebody else, a group of people may come in later, perfectly within the time frame the professor laid out, but because they came in after this discussion had already happened, they miss out, and nobody is responding to what they said, and they really become isolated within the class. Respecting the timing of the turn takes care of that, and so we all get to be a part of the discussion. Now, the law can be a controversial class. I will assign readings and videos, and you need to know up front that I don't necessarily agree with everything that I assign. My job here is not to try to get you to think the way I think. My job is to help you to develop your own way of thinking and to hopefully think more critically, more thoughtfully about situations and how they exist within the context of the law. And so we're going to have a lot of lively debate. We're going to throw a lot of ideas out there. We're going to critique those ideas. We'll critique each other, and you're welcome to critique me as well. And so the key to that is that we critique ideas, and we sometimes attack ideas, but we do so thoughtfully. We do so in a way that's not based just on opinion, but it's based on the law, and we do so without attacking people. And there's an art to doing that. But there's a particular art to doing that online, because I've been doing this for a long time, and I can tell you that things like affect and context don't easily translate to an online environment. You have to work at it. And so we have to both go out of our way when we're writing to provide context and to help people understand our inflection and our affect behind what we're saying. And as readers, we also have to be generous and give each other the benefit of the doubt and try to keep because you may feel really strongly about some of these issues, to try to keep that personal part in check and really try to focus on the ideas that are being debated and to be scholarly and academic about the way we debate those ideas. So those are some of my goals for the semester. You'll see in the syllabus that we do have these regular discussions. The semester is broken up into some key areas of the law. We do have an exam in the middle. It's an unusual exam. I'll tell you that right up front, and you'll hear more about that later. But it's an exam of practice as opposed to an exam of just regurgitating knowledge. And then at the end, I'll also ask you to provide a project where you identify some aspect of the law that we didn't get into. There's so much that we could study here and so much that we don't get to. So it'll be an opportunity for you to work either individually or ideally in some small groups and to dive into something that we didn't get to cover as well as you'd like us to, and to share some of that with the rest of the class. So I'm looking forward to this class. I haven't taught it in a couple of years, although I've taught this same class. First time I taught a class like this was 15 years ago. I've taught this at several universities across the United States. I took a 2-year break, and now I'm back. It's one of my favorite classes. And so I have a lot of passion for school law, and I'm looking forward to sharing that with you and learning from you this semester. So I hope you're off to a good start, and I'm looking forward to seeing you online.